Ask Tom on Home Show.
Anne from Lobelville, Tennessee has a question about attic condensation.
Yeah, Tom, she says, supposedly the man who built her home added a ridge vent but no soffit vents for her house. Anne writes to us, she says, we purchased several metal soffits for the front of the house and none in the back. And when it gets cold, our ceiling has water dripping into the house. What needs to be done to correct this problem? We thought about gable vents on the front since the builder put a small window in for decoration. Do you think that would help, Tom?
I think any ventilation at all is going to help. Ideally, you would have the proper amount of soffit vents and hopefully the proper amount of ridge vent. I don't know how much she has, but that's what we're looking at. But any ventilation at this point is going to help a lot. What's happening, and it's very simple, the attic's getting warm. It's cold out and you're heating the house. The insulation, sometimes, I should step back a minute. Sometimes the insulation on the floor of the attic needs to be increased also. So I'll hit on that in a minute. But attic ventilation, what it does is it removes the moisture, not allowing the moisture to become a liquid, which is condensate, which will start dripping from cold nails that stick through the roof decking or metal flashing that's exposed. There's different places. Sometimes it'll even get on the wood if the wood gets cold enough. And you get enough hot, humid air built up in the attic, it'll actually condensate on the wood and start to drip after the wood gets soaked, which is really bad because you can imagine that your structure is going to eventually rot. And so that's not a good thing either. But as far as it goes, more ventilation, the better. And it's going to be more than just opening a window in the attic. I think you're going to have a roofer or someone who you know in town that can come out and install full soffit vents to go with the ridge vent the way it should have been done. And if you want to put gable vents in, if you need them, I don't think you will unless you don't have enough soffit vents, but you'll have to go through the process to make sure you have enough. But the bottom line is this, it's just a matter of not having enough ventilation in the attic, number one, and the main reason. The second thing that can help is more insulation on the floor of the attic. So depending where you are in North Carolina, I wouldn't doubt they're requiring a minimum of an R42. And so if you don't have that R value on the floor of the attic in those older homes in that area of the country, it needs to be increased so that hot air that you're heating your house with isn't migrating into the attic and actually super warming it, is what we call it, up in the attic and causing that problem to get even worse.
When you talk about ventilation, you said you want to make sure you have enough ventilation. Is there a calculation she should be aware of in making sure that she does indeed have enough, Tom?
There is. There's a calculation, just like for the insulation. An R42 is probably going to be where they're at as a starting point in that part of the country. And as far as the calculation for ridge vents, there is a starting point. There's a minimum starting point, and that's for every 150 square feet of attic floor, you have 1 square foot of opening. And out of that 1 square foot of opening, 60% needs to be soffit, which means you have to have more intake than exhaust, and the ridge vent is the exhaust. So it's a 60-40 proportion. But remember, that's just minimums. You can increase ventilation, and you can have more. It's not going to hurt you. It's not real smart to increase on your R value because you get to a point where it doesn't do any good, because adding more and more is not always better. But with ventilation, you can't go wrong with it as much as you can get, making sure you get all the areas of the attic that are hard to get to. So you want to make sure that that's not ignored and where air can get trapped in those other areas. So you want to take a look at the whole attic and make sure it's evenly ventilated.
All right. You got a question? We can help you out just like that. All you have to do is go over to homeshowradio.com. Looks like this. Click on that blue button. It'll take you over to where our form is, and you can fill that out, send it in. We'll answer your question in a video that we'll post here at homeshowradio.com, our Facebook page, or our YouTube channel. And of course, you can listen to Home Show Radio anytime you want by visiting homeshowradio.com and clicking the Listen Now button.